Continuing our discussion about probabilities, let's take a look at the idea of conditional and joint probabilities. The basic idea behind a conditional probability is that a probability is calculated based on knowing another event, the other event being the condition, has in fact occurred. Now, given two events, A and B, the conditional probability of A given B is denoted as the probability of A, we use a vertical bar to represent given B. Okay, the probability of A given B. So this is saying that this event B has in fact happened. And what we're really doing is saying that, you know, I can probably find, or maybe I can find the probability of A, but knowing that B also occurred, I need to reevaluate the probability that A actually occurred. That's the general idea behind conditional probabilities. Now, going back to that table we've been working with, let's find the probability of a freshman. And then I want to find the probability of a freshman given that the student worked more than 20 hours. So I want two different things going on here. Okay, the probability of a freshman. That means freshman is my universe. If somebody was chosen, they were a freshman. And there are 66 ways that that could happen out of the total 280. So this probability will be 66 out of 280. So the probability of a freshman is 66 out of 280. Now, if this is sample data, then we should probably also add this hat here to indicate that we're dealing with empirical data. Now, what's the probability of a freshman given the student worked more than 20 hours? Well, see, given the student worked more than 20 hours, I'm thinking this as my universe. I'm saying this did occur. So anything else that can possibly occur must be in here. Well, how many ways can a freshman happen? That's 17. So I know that the probability of a freshman being chosen out of this data, given they worked more than 20 hours, has got to be 17 over 104. So I'm going to say that this is 17 out of 104. Now, the way we can calculate this, and what I just did, is I took the number of ways both events A and B can happen, both freshmen and they work over 20 hours. That was 17. And I divided it by the number of ways that event B can happen. Remember, B is now my universe. That's 104. So that's exactly where this thing came from. Given B happened, that's now my universe. Everything that can possibly happen is in that row, or it could be a column, depending on how it was defined. How many ways can A happen? Now, this previous statement, this probability of A given B, includes in it the idea of a joint probability. And the joint probability is simply the probability that two more events occur. In this case, the two events were both, they were a freshman, and they worked more than 20 hours. So I'll go back to the previous table. And I determine the probability that a randomly selected person is a sophomore and works 5 or fewer hours. So this would be a probability of a sophomore and works less than or equal to, whoops, I need to get my notation correct here, that my hours was less than or equal to 5. So if I go back to the table, let me erase it, freshman. Here's my freshman, and here's my less than or equal to 5 hours. Those are the two events. So I'm saying, what's the probability that they both occur? Well, the probability they both occur, right there, there's 24 out of how many? 280. So there's 24 ways that can happen out of the total. So that's 24 out of 280. So let me see, this is actually, we work it out right here. So the probability of sophomore and less than are equal to 5 hours is the number of ways that they both can happen. That was 24 divided by the total in the sample space. Total on that chart was 280, correct? Yes, 280. So there's my probability. And actually, that's really all there is to it. It's really kind of nice and easy when you're working with a chart. If I asked for the probability of juniors and work 10 to 20 hours, well, here's my juniors. Here's my 10 to 20 hours. Where they intersect, right there, that's the and. So that probability would be 12 over 280.